If you look at the nation of Namibia from orbit, you will notice a striking and unusual feature that is incredibly massive. Here, located in the west-central portion of the country and surrounded by darker-colored rock, is a massive, somewhat circular depression in the ground referred to as the Messum Crater. Stretching 21 kilometers or 13 miles wide, this geologic feature has such a large area that it could just about fit both the entirety of the cities of Paris and Washington, D.C. Yet, despite common perception, this feature is not an impact crater. Rather, it represents the remains of one of the largest explosive volcanic eruptions our planet has ever experienced. As Messum Crater, much like the far smaller Aniakchak Caldera in Alaska, represents a giant depression in the ground known as a caldera. And this caldera, which marks the spot of a long-extinct supervolcano, is incredibly old, as it formed between 135 and 132 million years ago. Approximately 135 million years ago, the African continent was still partially connected to South America, although Namibia was about 100 kilometers away from the eastern coast of Brazil. While some dinosaurs roamed the temperate rainforests of southern Namibia, temperatures in the north averaged 35 degrees Celsius or 95 degrees Fahrenheit. It is in this desert that our story begins, as one of the largest effusive eruptions in Earth's history was ongoing. What I am referring to are a series of eruptions which repeatedly flooded large swaths of Brazil, Argentina, Uruguay, Paraguay, and Namibia in hundreds of meters thick of lava. These individual eruptions were part of the Parana and Itendeka traps, which were a series of flood basalts. Each of their eruptions, which took place across a 4 million year time span, lasted for more than a decade, during which tens of thousands of square kilometers were covered in fast-moving lava. The source of this lava was the head of a mushroom-shaped mantle plume initially reaching the crust, with the relevant hotspot now far less active being today responsible for less voluminous eruptions on the remote island of Tristan da Cunha. While flood basalt activity did occur in Namibia, volcanism at the time generally consisted of lower volume but still large effusive eruptions, since it was at the very eastern edge of the mantle plume. At the spot which would eventually be the site of the Messum Crater caldera and supervolcano, large volumes of basaltic lava initially erupted onto the surface around 136 million years ago. Over the next several hundred thousand years, repeated effusive eruptions from the same central vent constructed a 2,000-meter-high shield volcano, which covered about the same area as the modern-day island of Oahu. However, over time, the eruptions this volcano produced grew more and more explosive as its at-depth magma underwent fractional crystallization. By 134 million years ago, basaltic eruptions had transitioned into more explosive and viscous flows of trachyandesite lava. While semi-frequent eruptions occurred during this period, it still represented less than the still massive input of magma from the mantle hotspot. Thus, as volatile-rich magma built up at depth, it was only a matter of time until a powerful eruption occurred. The first such powerful eruption blew away the top 300 meters of the volcano, creating a Plinian eruption column that towered to a height of 130,000 feet. Part of this very eruption column collapsed back to the ground, generating pyroclastic flows which incinerated everything within a radius of 60 kilometers. By the time this eruption had ended, some areas were buried by more than 100 meters or 328 feet thick of ash and pyroclastic flow deposits. Due to the 500 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock which were ejected, a 12-kilometer-wide caldera formed. Over the next 1.5 million years, three similarly sized massive eruptions occurred which continued to expand this caldera. Then, 132.5 million years ago, the true climactic eruption occurred, partially involving rhyolitic magma. This eruption lasted for approximately a week, sending 3 billion metric tons of sulfur dioxide gas into the atmosphere. Superheated pyroclastic flows annihilated everything within a 130 kilometer radius, while heavy ashfall stretched across the entirety of modern-day Namibia. In total, 6,300 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock was erupted in what was the planet's largest single explosive eruption until Toba's eruption 74,000 years ago. In the aftermath of the 21-kilometer-wide caldera's formation, rhyolite and trachyte lava domes erupted in its center, while gabbro intruded into ring dikes on the outer edge of the caldera. These intrusive rocks would later be exposed by more than 100 million years of erosion. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.